Ist noch jemand jetzt hier im Voice-Chat? Okay, in that case I can speak English, I guess. In the first run it's always important to just come through. Was not nice. But I will continue. Out the prison part. Still have problems with that turn. At the roof here, I'm gonna need a slide now. Bit safe. But I'm in the lead now. So I'm now close to the ending. Tight lines. And finishing with a 6:34, and I think that I'm kinda safe with that time. So this is a time that can be done kinda consistently, I would say. From this moment on, I can basically save it now. Let's open some music. Yeah, someone, Sixela was is overtaking me here. This is a sector where I lost a lot of time in my PB. Hallo Jaktor, hallo Danzer. Seconds ahead, which is not a big surprise because I had a big mistake in my other run in the start. Also this section was better. -4 seconds. Rip. So the top 50% after the time attack, after the 30 minutes, top 50% will come through. I don't know. Ah yeah, the half of all finishers. So we can't really say which position is enough. It depends on the finishers. But the top 50% will survive. That's a fine start. lost something here. Ah, damn it. The first half is definitely my worst half of this track. You see, I was far front of my time, but I was also far behind the first place, and I was also only on the sixth place. So all these hairpin parts, these blind parts, these labyrinths, they are not really suiting me that well. Also this start here. I'm just happy if I come through. It's not really about going quickly through that. Let's do that again. I mean, I'm pretty sure that I'm safe qualified with my time. But for the match, for rounds, I want to train a bit. And this is one of the parts that's very important. Let's do this run as a training run. Every part that I didn't go through, right before this Night Cup started in the replay editor. I was in the replay editor right before that, but I just warmed up on the last parts of the track. Especially this part is so decisive. Just train it. So easy to be too so easy to be too fast at a point here. At one turn. From these menus. Ah, there was a CP. nice when the car lands on its back wheels, then it accelerates quickly. Oh, so many messages in Trackmania Arbots channel. Okay. 11 minutes remaining, I'm still on 4th place. Now I will restart and go for another good time. Go for an improvement. I actually want to beat my PB because in rounds I'm usually not the guy who improves his times. I really have to watch out that I don't press the wrong button. There are so many buttons that I press on different occasions. So often you have to switch between cam 3 and cam 1, then in this part I use the backwards camera. Then interface on, interface off. And sometimes respawn checkpoints, and I hope that I don't press the respawn button in the wrong moment. Randomtransition.org. Lost some time. Scrappy is in front in that CP. These are the things, if they happen in rounds, that would hurt a lot. In time attack you try to YOLO through there. Sometimes things like this happen, which is not good. I'm still on 4th place with my time, with my first try. Tourist now coming through. Apparently he didn't have a good time before. So it took some time for him. And Skandair with a 6.22. Skandair with a very good time now. Oh, I just see that it's actually close to be the last try, so I completely forgot that the map length... It's not that long of an RPG, but... It's still 6.5 minutes and we have only 7 minutes to go, so I have to... get the run now if I want to improve. And I'm surprised I have not more advantage to my PB. Again, a little mistake in those blind parts. Really hate that. Lost some time there. But I improved. Oh, I got a bigger advantage now. Over 3 seconds. Was tight. Very fast now. In this jump. So have a look, I'm 4.7 seconds behind. Let's see what it will be in the end of this long engine killer section. Also 4.7, but I came closer to others. Spam actually not bad. Okay, improved. So we have lots of improvements. Scrappy with a 27.96, he's closely behind me. And well, I drove now a 29. was decent. Spam lost a lot in the end. I mean, he was on a sick time, actually. He could have been second here. So we have Zig Sela, Spam, Kevin Strike, Ariana G, and Deimos. How many finishers do we have? We have 18 finishers. That means the top 9 will come through, and the top 9 end at Deimos, who has a 6 minute 41. This is actually sick, the level. I mean, the level is really sick. Oh, we have a 19th finisher. We have a 19th finisher. 29 minutes. Yuke. He was joking. Nah, I think it doesn't count, they say. 18 finishers. So I guess Deimos was the last one, but wow. I mean, the last placed driver drove a 6 minute 41. So one respawn and you're basically out already. Oh, top 10 are in. So Masabi is also in with that. He got basically saved by Yuke, who made a troll finish. Waited all the time right before the finish line just to finish in the last second. But yeah, still, this is actually really sick, this level. Because they are all not far away, just good drivers driving. 10 minutes break, oh yeah. Okay, that is not 10 minutes break. So I will use this break to train some parts a bit more. Yeah, this is the thing that I don't want to happen, because this is also a long sector, you know? You start here, you respawn here, and you have to do the whole barrel roll again. I can... Yeah, probably it's the best way to really go slow. To release here a lot, and jump down like this. Because my landing is much better. My landing is so much better. I guess I will do it like this. So, the very important section here. I can also drive the whole part in Camp 3, maybe. The thing is, I didn't do it yet. So isn't it a bit too late to stop? To start now with that. But it makes sense, I think. Oh. This is so random. Hallo Dennis, Dude. Yeah, I gotta release there so I don't jump. I think. I think I will no slide this left turn now. The Neo slide is not easy there, and it's also a blind corner. In the end, I just have to get through there, and I have to have enough speed for the upcoming jump. That is the most important thing. Hallo Asteri. And this is exactly the mistake that. Oh, are they already? Had interface off. Okay, we start. Two players will get knocked out. Let's go outside here. Came now out of the sudden that we started. Ah. Wow. And I was so happy that I made the tube jump in the start. Barely made it around the corner. Oh shit. You know why that happened? I was so afraid of pressing a wrong button right now. I don't know. I was so afraid of pressing a respawn button. That's the reason for this. Almost I would have needed to press it. Because that was tied to fuck it up completely. But luckily I was able to still survive it. Somehow. Pressure is high. So I'm on the 8th place, so I'm in with this position, but of course I'm in the danger zone. I'm the last man to survive. But this is just the start of the map, obviously. Many parts to come, like this one, the prison part. Took me a lot of time to remember every corner here. And I still crash in those blind turns. Still 8th. A very safe approach. I see other cars in the top. There is also a car behind. Whew. I was on 9th. Now I came back to 8th, now I'm 7th. This is so fucking close. Wow. This is incredible close. And spam actually first. I got 6th. I got actually 6th. Still. Ariana 7th. Kevin 8th. Sixela, Skander, Tourist, Scrappy, Spam. I think the best players survived. Deimos and Masabi, who were on place 9th and 10th in the time attack, are both out. But you see how close this will be now. I mean, I can drive better, of course. I lost so much time in the start. I lost also time in other parts. And still I was 6th in the end. But yeah, this from the start, from the get-go, this is now tough. In other Night Cups, it was mostly the case that the first knockout rounds were so easy that they were kinda boring and you lost your focus completely. You could crash 40 seconds behind, was still okay. I don't feel safe in this jump. This is so shaky, this jump into the water. Holy moly. It's one of the parts that I don't really like, because it feels random. But I'm 5th, so there are some people with mistakes in this round already in the start. Top 6 will come through. So even though I lost some time here, currently I'm actually through. almost too fast here. Good speed. Fourth, someone fucked up. I think even the first place fucked up because I'm not far behind anymore. I just see where I lose time with saving, that I lose a lot of time. Spam just overtook me there. And again, I won 3 seconds onto the first place. So people in the front are making mistakes. Also won exactly one position there. So I can save the whole ending. I'm fourth, and there's a big gap behind me. So this is now a much worse round in total. In general. Oh, in the finish I'm actually third. Spam must have made a mistake in the end. Okay. So this round goes to Scrappy with a 31, Ariana with 32, I have 36, Spam 38 or something. And it's difficult to see. Scrappy, Ariana, myself, Spam, Kevin and Skander. And that's it. So Tourist is out and Sixela is out. Tourist is out. So now only the top 4 come through. This might be the most difficult round. Wait, I'm first. What is happening? Random slowdowns in those tubes, I don't like them. So there are huge gaps. Skandair is 19 seconds behind. Very safe round, and I'm actually first. So the pressure is really high. For all the players. 6 seconds in front. And I said this will be the most difficult round. But because usually it is the last round with top with two knockouts and only the top four comes through. My time is not that special, it's just 39 and I have 6 seconds. Ah. So Ariana G is second, Kevin gets through on third place. And then we have Scrappy coming through and it is Skandair and Spam. They will get knocked out. Ariana G, Kevin and Scrappy. Safe start, I just want to get into the run and now let's go. I wait long time until I start driving there. I don't want that the car goes up the wall. So Scrappy has a bad start, he's 10 seconds already behind. missed the way. I'm saving a bit too much. Oh, someone crashed. Okay, now I can save more than before. That was not clever, but I saved it perfectly. And this is still a 37 with that mistake. And Scrappy survives, Kevin is out. No. This is so random, this part. So random. I mean, I was so slow And still the car goes simply up there. Annoying. The map is otherwise too easy and this respawn was so fatal. It was so big. Also Ariana with a respawn. It's just 8 seconds. I won't give up. Go go. Now let's do the risky strats. Maybe Ariana thinks that he can save. Because it's me versus, behind. And if I drive good lines now, I can suddenly catch up and make Ariana nervous. That's the plan now. Only works if Ariana saves too much now. But also a mistake by Ariana and I'm through. So it's not done yet. I believe in my second place streak. I mean, I have to get second. So there must be something that happens to Ariana at some point. Coming closer, go go. It's possible, it's possible. 6 seconds. With a very good engine killer part. I have to risk this now. I have to risk the engine killer. Decent. Not perfect though. Respawn. I tried to take it nose slide with lots of speed. Scrappy lost sometime. Of course that doesn't help me at all. they are probably, yeah, they are basically in the finish. Map change. Lol. Yeah, that was more possible, of course, but this is the normal thing when you have one run where you have to respawn, then it requires a lot of luck to still survive. And this was just a too long respawn. My card took too long until it decided to roll over, and this is one of the worst sectors where you have to redo a whole section. But let's go into the final. We will be ready before knockout. Interesting. And we have Ariana with a grass slide, while Scrappy goes out. Since Scrappy goes into the lead, Ariana on second, but yeah, we know that other parts will decide here. My bet will go on Scrappy, that he will take it. But Ariana, of course, very experienced in RPG. I mean, in the end, it can't be decided by luck. You never know. We just will come now into the barrel wall. Both players get this, but now the water. Ariana is opting for... yeah. GG. This is the problem with RPG maps. Sometimes these finals are very anticlimactic. Ariana is doing a different strategy. There are two options. You can also turn your car around here. But what is safer? You saw that Ariana also flipped over, so you don't know what's safer. It is just... the car is not balanced when you go into this water, because these jumps before, these little platform blocks, they have an edge. You have transitions there. So even when you release a lot, you can't get the car balanced completely. It doesn't work. And this is the problem in this section. And you know the stadium car. When you're in the water, the stadium car likes to go up the walls when you touch it with a wheel. This is the dangerous thing there. Now both top 3 and the final will be decided by this, and probably also other players got knocked out because they flipped over there, I would assume. And yeah, with that, Scrappy now has kinda a free win. He can save every single part that is coming up. So far, it doesn't really look like he is saving. He's actually still going for a decent time. Scrappy opting for no slide lines here. This jump is one of the obstacles in the prison, but he makes it without any problems. There will be another flip coming up after this turn, but he knows this prison now. He knows that this jump is coming up, no problem as well. Difficult to say how far exactly he is ahead. Around 1 or 2 CPs, but that depends on the sector length, of course. So he will come into this respawn CP. It didn't respawn too early. So what can make him lose this? Basically, just one thing. the engine killer part. If he crashes the engine killer part, then there is a chance for Ariana. Because this is a huge sector. This is the last checkpoint. From here on, you have one sector, which goes like 40 seconds. But, I mean, he can save this engine killer part now. He doesn't need to do any risks. So let's see how he approaches it. He drifts a lot. And he also lands in a slide here. So he doesn't opt for the no-slide tactic that I'm doing for more speed. But he's just 2 or 3 kilometers per hour slower. So this is also still a very good and decent speed. He comes here with 55. You can be there with a high 60 number. But yeah, this is still very good and easy. I mean, he was also lucky. As I said, often it requires some luck. Scrappy also had rounds where he was far behind. The top 4 round, for example. He was dead last. And then Kevin made a mistake. And Scrappy survived. So in that round he was kinda lucky that he came through. But it's probably in any Night Cup, in almost any Night Cup, you might see no player that got through without any problems the whole time. There's always something that can go wrong. So this looked very safe. Ah, he's driving it like that, okay. I was never sure about this part. But he makes it without any problems like that, so yeah, it's a decent line. Yeah, no problems for him. Oh, ah, but he gets the CP. Now he has low speed, now he will get the water bounce, I'm sure. It's a decent round, I think. I mean, you saw that he lost here and there a bit of time. He saved a few parts as well. But this is still a very good time. It might be actually under 6:30. There's not much to say. There are not many bad parts where he lost a lot of time. And I think he had a good start as well. So he's doing that quite nice. Last sector now for Scrappy. He will win this Night Cup. Ariana second. I got third. GG. And the time is, yeah, very good. A 6 minute 26. This is incredible. I ask myself, why is he going for such a time? When Ariana is so far back. So Ariana, after that unlucky crash in the beginning, also with a decent round. A 6:50 means it's 23 and a half seconds behind, but this is kinda decent. I mean, this respawn did cost a lot, you saw it in my round.